Hello, welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2 Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We're back in Tugator, just because I felt like visiting here. And lo and behold, the Van Buren girl has transformed this place as well. And apparently the Red Pirate has locked himself inside here. Yeah, the place looks a little different. Look at the brightly colored cloths. I don't think we're even supposed to be here now, but why not?
Colorful cloths. They don't seem to fulfill any purpose, apart from being colorful.
Take? Alright, so I got one.
Not my style. Too crazy.
So here's the map.
The good captain always has the most important maps memorized, and so do I.
Then why do you need it? Stick the hammer.
Not much escaped the brat's magic.
Oh, look at the hammer.
This hammer is one of the lucky few. Looks kind of ceremonial, but there's no reason why it can't be used as a normal hammer.
Whack the little girl over the head so she stops her crap. Look at the laid table.
It's a powerful kid's magic that can force grown men to sit at tiny tables and pretend they like tea. Fortunately, I'm immune.
Yeah, let's see about that. Transformed buildings.
That's wrong. Impressive, but wrong. That's some transformation. There must be powerful magic at work.
Yeah, I could say that. Oh, these are all treats?
An unhealthy, artificial-looking, oversweet, fatty parody of a foodstuff. Wonderful!
Try one?
Hey! What are you doing there?
Trying your treats?
I'm, admiring the fine delicacies.
Those aren't for you. They're for my guests.
What guests?
If you want to take part, I'm going to have to make you pretty first.
Uh-oh.
Nope. No. That's all right. I'll keep my hands off your guests' food.
Nah.
As unhealthy and delicious as it might look, I'm not going to risk being transformed for it.
Okay.
The brat's keeping a watchful eye on the little snack for her guests.
Excuse me, sorry.
I won't get anywhere near it as long as she's here.
Do we really want them that badly? Flour?
That's the third biggest flour I've ever seen.
Third biggest, huh?
The flower is too pretty and smells too good to just be left alone.
I had no idea he liked pretty flowers like that.
A huge flower. It's giving off an absolutely disgustingly sweet smell.
Alright, let's look at this kid.
When Ivo told me about Seastone, I could hardly believe it. Even if the power of the brat's sorcerer grandpa is concentrated in the wand, where did he get all the power from? I'd better not speak to her. She could turn me into a small, hairy, pink critter in the blink of an eye. And who would want something like that hanging around?
That's your friend, you doofus.
I'd better not...
Excuse me, Miss Van Buren?
Lady Van Buren, I assume.
Yes? Who are you? What do you want?
You're a death. Who the hell is Wayne Schlegel? My name is Wayne Schlegel.
My name is Wayne Schlegel, from the Seastone Life and Accident Insurance Company.
Uh-oh.
What do you want here?
There was an accident here. A pirate lost an eye. Now he has to wear a wooden leg. There was clearly a problem in processing the claim.
She's gonna have her daughter transform
you. There's no one here anymore. Apart from that damned red pirate and the elf he's hiding.
Elf? What kind of elf?
Elf? What elf?
A thieving elf! She robbed me while I had to deal with the rest of her kind.
You've been to Elfboro? I heard it's supposed to be very pretty at this time of year.
We couldn't get in. Protective charms that not even my little darling could do anything about.
Thank God.
What a shame.
And then I'd go back home and find I've been robbed by that damned elf and her mob. They will suffer the consequences.
I can't stand her voice. Are you sure that the elf is here?
And you're sure the elf's here?
Of course! She flew here from Seastone on a magic hippogriff. We followed her trail to here, and there are no indications that the hippogriff has flown on.
So why don't you simply go in there and get the elf out?
You seem to have considerable magical power at your command, madam. Why don't you just magic the elf out of there?
If it were really so simple, do you really think I'd be wasting my precious time here?
Maybe.
That red scoundrel threatened us. Us! He has a magic weapon in there.
Oh yeah, the Medusa
hat. Ancient divine magic, which even my Chantel can't do anything against. Oh,
God, she's giving me a headache. Perhaps I can help. I could talk to the Red Pirate.
Perhaps I could go in there and talk to the Red Pirate. I'm an insurance salesman. No one would dare do anything to an insurance salesman.
That's true. And every hour that I waste here prevents me from taking care of the transformation of the country. Go in. Convince that old scoundrel.
Insurance salesmen aren't very beloved people. I admire your work, Lady Van Buren.
What you've done with this island is very impressive, Lady Van Buren. Just like in Seastone. You and your daughter are a real asset to this land.
Oh, thank you very much. Politicians so seldom receive the thanks that's due to them. Mm-hmm. One works tirelessly for years on end for oneself and one's friends. And do the electorate thank you for it? No.
Sad. Very sad. Then I may take my leave, Lady Van Buren?
Yes, yes.
The lady wants Ivo, and she won't leave until she has her. The fewer times I address her empty-handed, the better.
Well, Ivo is not here. Ivo is in Seastone.
I'd better not speak to her. As unhealthy and delicious as it might look.
Can I just go in there? How did he just get in? That's right, it's
stop.
Not...
Stop right there!
Locked.
Whoa, whoa, easy does it.
He's got the head of Medusa.
Put that thing away.
Wait! Have you seen what they've done to my island?
Yes. Even his blanket is funky looking. You did a bit of redecorating out there, I see.
Let me guess. You've redecorated. So the pirates that fled come back.
Oh, it was that little brat and her mother. Turned up here saying I should hand over the elf.
And you explained politely that the elf is no longer here and that unfortunately you can, as such, be of no help.
I kicked them out. Then they started transforming my island. They would have got me too if I didn't have the head.
How did you rescue the statues from Van Buren? This one looks like... He or she is doing some kind of twerking or something.
I see you were at least able to rescue the statues.
Statues? They're my friends. Tell him.
Friends!
I brought them in here long before them witches
friends.
Came. A man shouldn't be alone. Isn't that right, Martha?
Right.
Yeah. I've even heard of people who went mad because they had no one to talk to.
Can't happen to me. I've got friends, and things are on the up.
Friends?
Well, obviously you already know the Council of Van Buren is after Ivo.
Van Buren's convinced that Ivo's still here. I'm supposed to persuade you to hand her over.
Yeah, we'll just do that.
At the drop of a hat, that elf is in league with dark forces.
What?
She was trying to drive me crazy. Do you hear what she said about the invisible force that determines what we do?
Van Buren isn't going to believe that Ivo's not here.
You've got to get that old bag off my island, Nate. You have to.
What's in it for him? I need the spirit compass. Urgently.
I'm here because I need the spirit compass.
What? Not because you missed my company?
Nah.
And because I've missed your company.
Okay,
but
maybe.
But mainly the compass.
Hmm.
A friend of mine won't find their way out of the realm of the dead without it.
I don't care about that. It's my compass. Right, Pierre?
Well, then I'll just leave you here.
Right.
So you can transform the rest of your island. And, well, what if I rescue you from the counselor? Do I get the compass then?
How about I get Van Buren off the island, and in return you lend me the compass? You'll get it back in one piece.
You get rid of them both, mother and daughter.
Obviously.
That's the deal.
William, what do you say?
He can't say anything.
It's stew today!
Good old Bill. All you ever think of is food. All right, Nate. If you get those two monstrosities off my island, I'll lend you the compass for a day.
Deal.
One day?
Deal!
So our deal still stands?
Our deal stands?
Aye. You chase those two horrors off my island, and I'll lend you the spirit compass.
That's what I wanted to hear.
All right, we'll see you later.
I've got to go.
See you later.
See you later!
Alligator? Statue?
Perhaps old Red's friends can persuade him to give me the compass.
Well, we need that. We just need to get these two off the island. They'll give it to me. I can move the statue?
I'd better not. Old Red would notice if I moved the statue.
Why do we want to do it anyway?
I'd better not. Those aren't really friends of the Red Pirate. If they were, they'd have drawn his attention to the fact that he's completely lost his mind. I knew William. He doesn't talk as much now he's a statue, and he doesn't suffer from B.O. anymore.
What?
The bird doesn't sound anything like William, but if old Red can accept that William is now a statue, he's hardly going to care about his new voice. I knew William. The bird...
So, we can't look at this statue. Not fair.
Few books are consulted for words of wisdom as often as this one, but I think they rarely help.
Okay, I guess we're not that puzzled through that one again. Oh, there's a spirit compass.
The spirit compass. It can show the Archmage the way out of the spirit world. I only have to get rid of the Van Burens, then I get the compass. Sounds simple. The spirit compass.
Parrot.
The poor bird looks quite stressed out. I would be too if I was the one-man entertainer for a lunatic with a Medusa head. I wonder.
Talk to him. Rock? Pieces of height.
You should give Nate the compass.
Nate, was that you?
Absolutely not.
No.
Liar! Liar! I mean, no! No, liar!
I can see it's you, Nate, imitating other people. You inflated bonkey.
Imitating other
scandal,
people.
Scandal! It's me again!
What are you doing, Nate? Just stop it, will you?
Stop it!
What are you...
Stop!
Alright, what else can we do? Look at the cloth.
The Medusa head is the only thing keeping Van Buren out. No one in their right mind picks a fight with old magic like that. Neither does Van Buren. Old Red isn't a fighter. Otherwise, he'd storm out with the head and transform the Van Burens before they get him. I guess he thinks the safest way for him is just to wait. Hello?
Why? Have they gone?
Nope.
I've gotta go.
See ya.
See you later!
Alright. Let's look at this monkey.
The ape has got nothing to match the Van Buren's magic. But he could easily take me out if I try to steal the compass. The ape has got nothing to...
Alright, I guess we're going back out. So, hey, how about you just leave? That'd be cool, huh?
Lady Van Buren?
Yes?
The elf is not in the palace.
I've spoken to the Red Pirate. He says the elf fled before you even arrived.
Of course he says that! But he's hiding her!
I haven't seen her anywhere.
Then you haven't looked properly enough. I want that elf. Bring her to me.
Then I may take my leave, Lady Van Buren?
Yes, yes.
She's leagues away, I'm afraid. I'm gonna actually talk to her.
Hello there.
What do you want? Go away.
Never. You're the daughter of Lady Van Buren, aren't you?
I'm Nate. You're the Council Leader Van Buren's daughter, right?
Uh-huh. And you are not invited to my party.
What a meanie. So you are having a tea party, I see.
A tea party, huh?
Exactly like in my book. I'm celebrating my birthday.
Unbirthday?
I've got a table, tea, and lovely things to eat, and any minute now the guests will arrive. The Mad Hatter and the White Rabbit.
Oh, really?
And then I'll get presents.
May I come to your tea party?
I'd love to be a guest at your tea party.
Ew, you can't come. You aren't a Mad Hatter, and you're not a White Rabbit either. And you're a boy, and ugly.
Sheesh.
Now listen here.
I can make you pretty.
No.
Thank you, but that's not necessary.
Are you sure your guests are coming?
And this Hatter and Rabbit? Will you make them appear by magic?
No, I can only change things. They will come here. I've done everything exactly the same as in my book, so they've gotta come. I always get very angry if I don't get exactly what I want.
Okay.
And they all have to bring me presents, and when the Hatter and the White Rabbit are there, then Mommy has to come over as well.
It's only a few steps away.
Right, Mommy?
What, sweetie?
When the other guests have arrived, then you'll come over too and give me an unbirthday present, right?
Of course, my sweet. As soon as a Mad Hatter and a White Rabbit appear, then I'll give you the most super-duper present ever.
Ha! Did you hear that? The biggest, bestest present ever!
She's lying to her. So it's an unbirthday, like a non-birthday, just like not her birthday. Pretty what you have done to the town.
Quite, pretty what you've done with the city.
I got it all out of my book, and Mommy says I've got a real artificial talent.
Artificial?
Artistic. Although, artificial works too.
Tell me about the Mad Hatter.
Who is this Mad Hatter you're expecting?
He's a hatter, and he's mad.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And what is it that makes him a hatter? And what makes him so mad?
He wears a top hat and a colorful neckerchief, and I'm not sure why he's mad, but he is.
I see.
Tell me about the White Rabbit.
A White Rabbit at a tea party? Curious.
You think?
Yeah, And perhaps you should give him a watch if he doesn't turn up soon.
No, my guests have to give me a present.
I would say that you're done here. Why don't you go and transform something else?
Wouldn't it be fun to move on and transform something else? Or to travel back to Seastone and have an afternoon nap?
Mommy's looking for the elf who stole things from us.
Yes, but aren't you the one in charge here? Just tell her you want to go somewhere else.
But I've got everything ready for my tea party, and the guests will arrive any minute.
It's just a lie she told you.
I've got to go.
Yes, otherwise you'll scare my guests away.
Hello there.
What are you doing?
What do you want? Go away!
Your guests still haven't arrived, huh?
Still no guests yet?
No. Maybe they're buying me even better presents. As soon as they get here, Mommy's gonna give me the biggest and bestest present ever!
I've gotta go.
Yes? Otherwise you'll...
Yeah. Alright, can we go up here into the observatory?
Just one more piece! Just one more little piece and you've done it!
Piece of what?
Hey, Eyes!
Nice! Nice to see you again.
Come on! Knowing you, you never lost sight of me.
Your life wasn't so boring over the past few years, I must admit. Good season.
Season. From what I can see, you have not been changed.
I half expected to find you transformed into a huge ball of fluff with big goggle eyes.
The council leader and the charming Chantal are concentrating their attention on the palace. Fortunately.
I guess you also wander off the island as quickly as possible.
Absolutely. I like tragedies, but I've never wanted to be in one.
Right, yeah. Ivo's mother has put her into a deep sleep.
Know why I'm here?
You probably saw it through the mirror.
Of course, Princess Ivo. Look at her.
Sleepy.
Isn't it sad? An elf in the prime of her life, sleeping away her best years.
I'm going to prevent that from happening.
And I hope you're successful. This is more boring than watching the cricket.
How can I rescue Ivo?
Ivo's father said I can't rescue Ivo against her mother's will.
That would be a bad idea. Although I'd like to see what would happen if you tried.
Sure you would.
So how can I convince Ivo's mother that she's not acting in her daughter's best interests?
Isn't she? The future's in constant flux. Even I can't see it clearly in my mirrors. A powerful priestess like her might be able to see more, but clearly she doesn't want to.
She thinks Ivo's thrown her life away. And she thinks it's impossible that she could be happy with a child. Or with me.
A difficult task that you... Come on, number three! Run! Come on! Yes! Sundancer won!
Alright, calm down. Do you know who the father of Ivo's child is?
Ivo's pregnancy. Do you know who... you know?
Ivo said you weren't the father. But if not you, who?
I'm not the oracle with 100 eyes. How should I know who it is?
Eyes that are blind if there's no reflective surface nearby. Ivo seemed very surprised by the news herself. She spoke of a curse that might have struck her.
A curse? Yeah, sure.
Well, why would she tell that to him? To the... well, this. the oracle. The mirror showing Ivo. Can I have it?
Can I have that mirror?
Of course not!
Is it this one?
I could always keep an eye on Ivo with it, and maybe it'll come in useful some other way.
It's already useful. It means I can see what happens next in the story. Anyway, I've never given any of my mirrors away. They are rare collector's items.
You collect mirrors? Rewind. Delete. Stupid question.
Give it to me.
Can I have that mirror?
Of course! course not!
I could always keep an eye on...
It's already use... Anyway.
You could... Rewind.
I gotta go.
Yes, go! Henceforth!
Tally-ho! Happy children.
Some happy children playing in a garden. Ivo's mother refuses to believe that Ivo's children could have a happy future, too. Who cares if the future queen has an illegitimate child? Well, apart from me. Some happy Ivo... Who cares? Well...
And this mirror, is this the one with Ivo?
Some mirrors show different scenes the whole time. Others always show the same.
The connection between two mirrors is sometimes stronger and sometimes weaker. This one here has a particularly strong connection to the mirror in Ivo's room. Just look how clear the picture is.
Take.
About the mirror.
Just a second. Something exciting's happening. I can't miss this.
Well, he's distracted.
Oh,
get it.
About the mirror.
Just...
What about this mirror?
Thousands of lives are taking place behind these mirrors. Tragedies, comedies, and quite a lot of everyday life. Hello?
Yes? What is it?
Yeah, that's it.
I gotta go.
Yes! Go!
All right.
The brat's keeping a watchful eye on the little snack for... I won't get anywhere near...
Wait, I was trying to hold that. Knock Chantel Van Buren out. Knock Lady Van Buren out. Cool.
Violence is never the solution. In my experience, the absurd combination of bizarre objects is the solution. Always.
Yeah, really.
Violence, in my...
Wait. Oh, he put it on? He's dressed for her party.
Violence is in my...
They're not here yet.
Hello. I am... I'm the Hatter. The Mad Hatter.
No, you're not.
Nah.
A hatter without a hat? No such thing.
I lost it.
Oh, the top hat, of course.
Oh, God.
Almost.
I gotta go back to Elfboro and get that leprechaun hat from the library. Oh. All right.
Hello. I am...
No, you're a hat.
Almost. The lady wants Ivo and she won't leave until she has her.
All right, we gotta run back.
Away we go.
Okay, we're there now. There's the elf pearl.
Cast off.
Give me that thing. Now, only now I can take it.
A green top hat. It should be useful. Green top hats always are. A green top hat.
All right.
Away we go.
Hi. I'm the Mad Hatter now.
Hello. I'm the Hatter. The Mad Hatter.
Just like in my book! Are you really mad?
Yep, I'm pissed.
Sure, completely insane.
That too.
I think you're a revolting child, and you have terrible taste.
You must be really mad if you're making fun of me! Have you got a present for me, too?
I've got a speaking telegraph here.
I've got a great gadget for you. A magical communicator.
Oh, the cans.
A what?
If you pull the string tight and someone speaks into the tin at one end, you can hear what he says at the other end.
That's completely lame. If you want something, then you could just scream loudly for it.
Yeah.
But it's not lame.
It is. And totally impractical with all those cables and all.
Yeah, it's not wireless.
Huh. Now it'll work without the stupid cable.
Hmm. Even better.
Say what? That isn't a present. I want a real present. Something that I can hold.
It's not really all about presents, you know.
I hereby present you with the insight that life isn't about receiving presents.
Say what? That isn't a present, stupid. I want a real present.
Yes, but you see...
Whatever! My mommy's gonna give me a real big present.
Okay, so you don't need one for me.
But
I want a present!
A present! Of course! Hi.
Oh, Hatter! Have you got a present for me?
What sort of present do you want?
And what kind of presents would you like?
Good ones! Anyone wishing to come to my own birthday party must give me a good present!
And what is a good present?
I like sweet and fluffy animals, I like things for girls, and I like fairy tales!
So you don't want the flower? So what is this? Transform telephone?
If these things could transmit voices over large distances without the string, the possible uses would be tremendous.
Yeah.
You could contact people you didn't know and pretend to be someone else. Or you could call them up during mealtime in order to sell them something.
Never mind, be productive and actually communicate with them. So gotta find some kind of present for her.
The lady wants Ivo and she...
It's funny how she keeps knocking and knocking, we just walk right in. You got anything fluffy?
Hello?
Hi. Have they gone?
No. No.
I've gotta go.
See you later.
See you later!
I'd better not. The ape has got nothing to match the Van Buren's magic. But he could easily take me out if I try to steal the compass.
Well, maybe I have to go to another land to fix this. I don't suppose we can give her the hippogriff.
You still hungry?
Nah.
We should do something about that.
I don't have anything to eat. Unless it wants a flower. Give the flower to Critter as a present.
I like Critter, but I don't want to pick out curtains or anything.
This is just giving it to him normally.
Hey, Critter.
Huh? That's it.
Get it. I've got everything under control.
Alright guys, thanks for watching. I guess we're gonna see what other lands we can go to. Maybe we'll find a good present for little Van Buren here. See you next time in a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.